Hello, I'm Kent Weakley, and today I'm going to show you how to make this photo. This is a really specific location on the Oregon coast called Thor's Well, and it's a very cool place to go photograph. However, it's incredibly dangerous. Let me show you some images here. Just beside Thor's Well is another location called the Sprouting Horn. This Sprouting Horn is a connection of underwater passages of hollow stone. This is all lava rock. And so there's hollow passages through it, and the force of the tide and the waves coming in push the water through these various cavities and make these incredible spouts. This is a sixth of a second image, just over half a second. You can see what this looks like. You can see the size of the waves coming in here. And this is Thor's Well. Thor's Well is sitting on the edge of this rock ledge. And again, this is volcanic rock. Volcanic rock with various crustaceans on it. It is very jagged and sharp and dangerous. If you talk to the locals there, they will mention the fact that you never, ever want to turn your back on the ocean. There are things called rogue waves, which can come out of nowhere. There are waves that will have more force than others. It's not necessarily something like you're going to see a big wall coming at you, like a huge wave. But there could be a low wave that has a tremendous amount of force on it, that when it gets to the land, it just keeps going. Those types of waves are pretty rare, but they do happen. And this is definitely not the place to get caught not paying attention. Because the absolute last thing I could even imagine is getting sucked down into this hole. So anyway, needless to say, this was a little bit hair-raising to go out and photograph. Let me show you a few more images. This, just to give you a sense of scale too, this is about the size of a small swimming pool. I would say maybe it's probably similar to like four or five hot tubs. It gives you an idea. Here is a video that I shot that you can see. So you can see the flow of the water so you can understand what's coming and going here and what we're working with as far as capturing this image. You can see how the well is completely filled to the top. And when it's filled to the top, there's really nothing to shoot there. If you shoot at that point, you're going to have these full images that look like this, and you can't see the well at all. So timing is critical. You're going to need to know your tables pretty well for this one. You're going to need to know when the tide is rising or when it's receding. You're going to need to know when sunset occurs, because you could have the sun setting in the distance behind this as part of the image. Unfortunately, this was a cloudy day for me and I did not get sun here. Once I started shooting, basically what I did is I approached this hole in the ground slowly and cautiously. I shot it with my medium format lens, my 28 to 70 millimeter Nikon 2.8 lens. I'm on a tripod because obviously these are going to be slow exposures. Now, they're slow exposures because we want that water that's streaming over the side of the well to be blurred and softened. When I do that long exposure, the camera needs to be stable. So it's on a tripod and I have a cable release. As I approach this well, I am carefully positioning the tripod on the rocks and getting a good stable footing before I shoot. And as I'm feeling a little more comfortable, I move forward closer and closer to Thor's Well to get a more dramatic image. And I'll show you here several of the different versions of the shot that I made. You can see in this one that the well is almost filled. this whole area inside here is getting pretty full, and it's the timing's not quite right. So the timing of the shot was almost as critical as the tide coming in. Here I was back a little ways. You can see the jaggedness of these rocks. This is kind of the rock shelf that the Thor's well is located on. Here's a shot that I shot from up at the parking area just off the highway. You can see there's another photographer down off to the right, and he's being a little cautious too. He's nowhere near Thor's well. He's off a good 50 feet away from him. Here between these two images, you can see Thor's well empty and full. You can see how the ocean is literally right at the level of this entire shelf of rock. So I moved closer and I started getting my timing down and started realizing when I needed to fire the shutter in order to get this look that I was looking for. And essentially what it turned out to be is once the well would fill completely up and it would start receding, I would start the shot then. And then I would get the dripping trails of water coming down the sides in this long exposure. This happened to be 1.3 second exposure. So in this exposure, essentially, I'm starting to get the look that I'm looking for at this point. Here in the foreground, I'm getting some really cool swirled water effect. Again, this is 1.3 second. Now, I had to slow this down because even though it was overcast, it's still relatively bright. So I'm shooting the Nikon D800E, and I was able to bring this down to an ISO of 50. On that camera, it only says ISO 100, and then it has two or three lower settings. For whatever reason, they don't label this as ISO 50. But essentially, if you dial down past those three, the very bottom is the equivalent of an ISO 50. So it's giving me a really slow sensor capability, and I'm able to shoot F18 at 1 1/3 second. Here I backed up. I had shot pretty close here, and that was kind of interesting. And then I backed up a bit, and this is the shot that I really liked. So let me show you how I processed this in Lightroom. And this is a pretty dramatic adjustment in Lightroom. There's quite a few things that have been changed here. I really wanted to make this scene more dynamic. I'm going to go back and show you what this looked like originally. This is the image straight out of the camera, and this is what I created. Now let me go ahead and reset this, and I'm going to show you what I did to make this image. First off, the color is, the white balance is pretty balanced actually, although it's really drab. So what I want to do is I'm going to cool this down. I'm going to do that by adjusting the overall temperature. I'm going to bring that down. I don't want to bring it out too far. It'll get crazy out here, like a posterized effect if you go too far. I'm going to bring it probably about in this range. Now, what I was really hoping for was a nice sunset orange sky in this background on the horizon, which didn't happen. But we can emulate what it might have appeared, how it may have appeared, with some sunset colors in here. What I'm going to do is I'm actually laying a gradient overlay, and I'm going to add some color to this. I'm going to warm it. I'm going to warm this overlay, and I'm going to tint it magenta. I've also added a color cast to it, the orange color cast. And I'm gonna bring the exposure down just on this gradient overlay, just a bit there. I'm noticing that in the water, I'm really not getting as much detail as I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this gradient overlay. And I'm gonna bring the exposure down just a touch. I'm gonna increase the contrast. That's giving me more of the look I'm looking for here. I'm going to add a little bit of clarity. That's going to crisp things up a bit. Now I can really see the flow of current going down into this well very nicely. I like that. I'm going to look at the detail here, and I'm going to sharpen this. Now, of course, the water is not going to be sharp, but the rocks should be because they're not moving. At least I would hope they don't move. An earthquake, of course, would move them. That would have been way more drama than I probably could have handled at that moment. So basically, the whole time I'm doing this, I've got my left hand on one of the legs of the tripod. Everything's tightened down as tight as I can get it because I'm essentially ready to just lift that tripod up and turn and haul out of there if I need to, if a wave comes up or if we get a really big surge of water coming through that well. Luckily, nothing happened, so I was able to get this image, and I was very pleased with it. Now, the only thing I'm seeing here is the bottom of this image is a little bit bright, and I really want the eye to stay focused on the well. So what I'm going to do is another gradient overlay from the bottom up. And on this one, I'm simply just going to take the exposure down. This is going to darken that area. Look how that immediately helps us focus in the central area of this image. Now, the other thing with long exposures that you need to be aware of is that if you have any spots on your sensor, they are definitely going to show up. So what I'm going to do is with a spot removal tool, I've used the bracket keys here to simply change the size of the brush. I'm holding the space bar down and then I can click, hold, and drag around the image. These little dust spots have a tendency to hang around the outside corners. Just like dust in a room, they tend to go towards the corners. So I'm going to look over there and see what I can find. And I'm just going to move around the image and clone out all of these little dust particles. Yeah, it's a great idea to get your sensor cleaned or have it cleaned before you go out and do a shoot like this. If that's something that interests you, I have a three-part series on cleaning your camera sensor in my YouTube videos. Okay, it looks like I got them all. Go ahead and close that. If you want to see those, you can click on the blemish tool here and it'll show you all the locations where those have been done. Now, the other thing that could be interesting is to create a little more highlight in the center of this, and I can do that with the brush tool. And again, I can use the bracket keys to go to increase or decrease the size of this. What I want to do is increase the brightness of the water in the well. Kind of bring your eye in there. If you hit the O key, that's for overlay, it shows you what you've brushed and what hasn't been brushed. I'm going to leave that for now. So I'm going to undo that little piece, make it a little smaller here, and brush across. Okay, so I'm going to hit O again to hide that. Now I'm going to go and make the adjustment to this. First off, I'm going to take the exposure up just a bit, as well as the contrast. I'm going to add a little clarity. I'm going to leave it right there for now. I think that looks pretty good. We could turn that off with a little toggle switch at the bottom, off and on. You can see the difference there. And essentially, that's it. Here's the before, and there's the after. If you decide to go out and shoot this, please be cautious. Be safe about it. If you've got somebody with you, take them with you down there and play it safe. Better safe than sorry. And remember, this is all about timing. It's about the timing of getting the water in the right place and then the timing of firing your shutter release at the right time to capture the look of this well. So I hope you enjoyed this. Please like this video. And if you're not already subscribing, please do so. I've got a ton of other information on my blog, and I also do workshops and all sorts of different things to help photographers. So check out my blog if you would. And until then, as always, happy shooting.